So I'll talk about 0-1 kilos and extended 0-1 kilos for random distance graphs. Let's start with some basic definitions. First of all, Erdős-Rényi random graph GNP. Here we have n vertices and connect pairs of vertices with probability p independently from each other from other pairs of vertices. And now a more general model of a random graph. Suppose we have a sequence of graphs Gn. Then random graph GGnP is a random element with values in omega Gn and distribution PGnP on FGn, where omega Gn is the set of all spinning subgraphs of Gn. And the probability of a given graph G is equal to p to the power of number of edges in G multiplied by 1 minus p to the difference between the number of edges in Gn and in G. So we have a random subgraph of Gn. And later we'll consider the case when Gn is a sequence of random graphs. It's a sequence of distance graphs. And this will be a random distance graph. So let's define 0-1 law for random graphs. In order to do this, we need the definition of first order properties of graphs. They're defined by first order formula, which are built of predicate symbols, logical connectivities, variables x, y, etc., which correspond to vertices of the graph, and quantifies for all and exists. And we say that the random graph GNP follows 0-1 law if for any first order property L, the probability that this random graph satisfies L tends either to 0 or to 1 as n tends to infinity. And now one more definition, 0-1 K law. Here we consider only first order properties which are defined by first order formula with quantifier depth at most k and require the same condition. And now I'll tell you about some classical results on the 0-1 law for random graph GNP. This theorem was proved by Glebsky and others in 1969 and then independently by Fagin in 1976. We suppose that the function p of n satisfies the property. This property means that this function does not tend neither to 1 nor to 0 too quickly. Then the random graph GNP follows the 0-1 law. And later, Scheller and Spencer proved the following result. If p of n is equal to n to the power minus beta, and beta is an irrational number from the interval 0-1, then the random graph also follows the 0-1 law. And now I'd like to pass over to 0-1 law for random distance graphs. Let's define the model of random distance graph we are going to consider. We have a sequence GN dist. This sequence is defined by two functions, A of n and C of n. The vertex set of this graph is the set of all n-dimensional vectors with coordinates in the set 0, 1, such that the sum of all coordinates equals A. So we can say that we consider n-dimensional 0, 1 vectors with A, 1 coordinates, and n minus A, 0 coordinates. And we can connect two vertices with an edge if and only if the Euclidean scalar product of these two vectors is equal to xi. So this graph is a distance graph because edges connect vertices at some fixed distance. So let's formulate a result on the 0-1 law for such model of a random distance graph. We suppose that the function p of n satisfies the following property. This property is similar to the property which was used in the theorem by Glebsky, but here we replace n by the number of edges in our distance graph. Oi, the number of vertices in our distance graph. Then the following theorem is true. Suppose that A is equal to alpha n, C is equal to alpha squared n, and alpha is a rational number from the interval 0, 1. Then the random graph GGNP does not follow the 0, 1 law. But there exists a subsequence, GGNIP, following this law. So we see that for the random distance graph, the situation isn't the same as for random graph GNP. There are sequences of random distance graphs which follow the 0-1 law, and there are also sequences which do not follow the 0-1 law. And when we look...
What is P?
P? P is the probability of an edge, as in Odeschrenie, a random graph, and it satisfies...
Oh, that satisfies
this. This property. And when we look at this result, some questions about the behavior of the random graph in relation to 0-1 law arise. First of all, when does a given subsequence GGNIP follow 0-1 law? In that theorem, we just proved that there exists such a subsequence. And another question is connected to the way how we disprove 0-1 law for the whole sequence GGNP. The fact is that in order to disprove the law, we find two subsequences, Ni and Mj, such that for one of the subsequences, Ni, the probability of some property tends to 1, and for other subsequence, the probability of the same first-order property tends to 0. So we have two subsequences with different limits, but both limits are equal either to 0 or to 1. And it's natural to ask the following question. Does there exist a first order property L and a subsequence GGNIP such that the probability of this property L tends to a number from the interval 0-1? And we also can reformulate this question in the following way. What limiting probabilities PGNIP of L can we get? And in order to answer these questions, we'll introduce the definition of extended 0-1 kilo. We say that the random graph GGNP follows extended 0-1 kilo if for every property L defined by a first order formula with quantified depth at most k, any partial limit of the sequence PGNP either equals 0 or equals 1. So when we considered 0-1 kilo, we required the existence of a limit and also required that this limit is either 0 or 1. And here we don't require the existence of a limit of this probability, but there could not be any partial limits from the interval 0-1. And so the second question from this slide is equivalent to the question whether GGNP follows extended 0-1 law. And our goal is following. We'd like to find conditions on the sequence GGNIP under which one of the following takes place. First, 0-1 kilo holds. Second, 0-1 kilo does not hold, but extended 0-1 kilo holds. And third, extended 0-1 kilo does not hold. Before I pass to the result about 0-1 kilo and extended 0-1 kilo, I'd like to briefly describe how we got the result of the mentioned theorem. And I'd like to explain reasons why the random distance graph did not follow 0-1 law. When we prove 0-1 laws, we use Ehrenhold theorem. And let's define Ehrenhold game for two graphs. Suppose we have two graphs, G and H, and a number K, which is the number of rounds in the game. Here there are two players, pole and duplicator. They, in each round, at first, spoiler chooses a vertex, then duplicator chooses a vertex from the other graph, and duplicator wins if and only if the induced subgraphs on chosen vertices are isomorphic. And the following theorem shows the connection between 0-1 laws and Ehrenhold games. The random graph GGNP follows 0-1 kilo if and only if duplicator wins Ehrenhold game on two random graphs GGNP and GGMP with k rounds, where k is the quantified depth, with probability tending to 1 as n and m tend to infinity. So in order to prove 0-1 kilo, we can just give a winning strategy for duplicator. And Glebsky and others proposed a full level extension property in order to give this winning strategy. We say that the graph G satisfies full level T extension property if for any vertices v1, etc., vl, and u1, etc., ur, where the total number of vertices is not greater than t, there exists a vertex v adjacent to all vertices from the first group and non-adjacent to the vertices from the second group. And they proved the following proposition. Let GGNP satisfy full level k minus 1 extension property asymptotically almost surely. Then the random graph follows 0-1 kilo. And this proposition has the following corollary for 01 law, because 01 law holds if and only if 01 key law for any key holds. So in order to prove the theorem about 01 law for a random distance graph, I also used full level extension property. And let's formulate a result about full level extension property for random distance graph. We suppose that A is equal to alpha n, and alpha is a rational number from the interval 0, 1. Then the random graph GGNIP satisfies full level T extension property asymptotically almost surely for every natural number T, if and only if C is equal to alpha squared by n, and for any natural number m, ni is divisible by m for sufficiently large I. So it is a necessary and sufficient condition for a random distance graph to satisfy full level extension property for any level T. And this proposition implies the theorem about 01 law. Indeed, we can choose a subsequence ni such that for any natural number m, ni is divisible by m for sufficiently large I. And for such subsequence, GGNI dist P satisfies full level extension property, and therefore 01 law holds. But if we consider the whole sequence GGNP, then there are subsequences ni such that ni isn't divisible by m, and therefore there are subsequences which satisfy full level extension properties and subsequences which do not satisfy full level extension property, and it says that 01 law doesn't hold. And here remains a question whether the subsequences for which full level extension property doesn't hold, whether such subsequences follow 01 law. And now a statement about full level extension property for a fixed level T. We suppose that A is equal to alpha n, C is equal to alpha squared by n, and we take a natural number T not greater than 5. Then the random graph GGNIP satisfies full level T extension property asymptotically almost surely if and only if the differences A of an I minus C of an I are divisible by dt for sufficiently large numbers I. And numbers dt are determined as in the following way. So we have we again have some divisibility conditions. From the fact that d2 is equal to 1, we immediately get that GGNIP satisfies full level 2 extension property, and therefore 013 law always holds. And what about 01 key law for larger key? We use following notation. A is alpha n, C is alpha squared n, and alpha is S over Q, a fraction. So we have the following theorem about 01 for law. First, the random graph GGNP follows extended 01 for law. And second, the sequence GGNIP follows 0, 1 follow if and only if there exists i0, say that all the numbers a minus c for I greater than i0 have the same parity. And now 0, 1, 5 law. We suppose that a sequence ni is such that all numbers a minus c are even for large I. Then extended 0, 1, 5 law holds. And second, 0, 1, 5 law holds if and only if there exists i0 such that either all numbers a minus c are divisible by 3 or all numbers a minus c are not divisible by 3 for large I. Okay, now 0, 1, 6 law. We suppose that the denominator of our fraction alpha is not equal to 5, and the sequence ni is such that these differences are divisible by 12 for sufficiently large I. Then, again, a random graph follows extended 0, 1, 6 law, and a sequence follows 0, 1, 6 law if and only if numbers a minus c are either all divisible by 5 or all not divisible by 5. So, in all these theorems, we have that extended 0, 1 k law holds, and 0, 1 and simple 0, 1 law depends only on some divisibility conditions, whether these differences a minus c are divisible by some numbers. And one may conjecture that indeed everything depends only on divisibility conditions. And if we take a sequence ni such that all the numbers a over ni minus c over ni have the same residuous modular numbers m for large I, then these sequences will follow 0, 1 law. This would imply that the random graph follows extended 0, 1 law. But unfortunately, it is not true. And furthermore, we can disprove extended 0, 1 k law for small k's. I remind you that we consider functions p of n satisfying this property. And we have the following theorem. Suppose that one of the following two cases take place. First, q is equal to 5, and a sequence ni is such that all numbers a minus c are not divisible by 5 for sufficiently large I. Or second, alpha is equal to 1 second, and a sequence ni is such that all the numbers a minus c are not divisible by 4. Then in both cases, there exists a function p of n satisfying this property such that the sequence dgnip doesn't follow extended 0, 1, 6 law. So this means that there exists a first order property L with quantified depth not greater than 6, for which the limiting probability is a number from the interval 0, 1. And I also would like to note that here we only have a finite number of alpha, either 1 second or denominator equals 5. And now a result for infinite numbers of alpha. We suppose that the denominator of alpha is an even number, and alpha belongs to the interval 1/4, 3/4. And the sequence in I is such that these differences, A minus C, are not divisible by 4 for large I. Then, again, there exists a function, P of n, satisfying that condition, such that the random graph doesn't follow extended 0-1 law. So we disprove extended 0-1 law for this interval of numbers alpha. And I'd like to note that it isn't necessary for alpha to belong to this interval and the denominator to be even, and it is also possible to disprove extended 0-1 law for alpha not belonging to this interval. The situation with 0-1 law for random distance graph is much worse than for G of NP. Okay, these are the main results. And now I'd like to tell you about the proofs. We need the following definition. Vertices V1, etc., Vt are said to form a special T set if there doesn't exist a vertex V adjacent to all of the vertices V1, etc., Vt. It's obvious that if the sequence of graphs Gn, if graph Gn contains special T sets, then the random graph GGNP doesn't satisfy full level T extension property. And it turns out that for a random distance graph, the converse is also true. Let's define the following property of spanning subgraphs of Gn. For any vertices V1, Vt, not forming a special T set in Gn, and for any subset U of the set V1, etc., Vt, there exists a vertex V adjacent to all vertices from U and non-adjacent to all vertices from V1, Vt minus U. For every natural number T, the random distance graph Gn dist P satisfies property RT asymptotically almost surely. So special T sets are the main obstacle for the random graph to satisfy full level extension property. And so how can this property help us to prove 0-1 K-law? We make two suppositions. First, here we can consider an arbitrary sequence of graphs Gn, not necessarily distance graphs. We suppose that the graph Gn doesn't contain special T minus 1 sets. And the random graph GGNP satisfies property RT asymptotically almost surely. Then we have the following proposition. We suppose that a sequence of graphs Gn satisfies these two properties and also following conditions. Gn has special T sets. And second, for every special T set, any two of its vertices are non-adjacent. Then the random graph follows 0,1 t plus 1 law. So when we prove t plus 1 law, we are interested in special t sets, and we have such two conditions about them. And this proposition allows us to prove 0,1 k law in the case when there are no edges between vertices of special t sets. And what if there are such edges? We again suppose that the sequence Dn satisfies those two properties, and also for any I vertices, V1, etc., Vi, where I is less than T, one of the following holds. First, for any vertex Vi plus 1, such that vertices V1, etc., Vi plus 1 can be extended to a special T set in graph Gn, there exist not less than the number of vertices to the power of beta, different vertices, each of which can be mapped onto Vi plus 1 by an automorphism of Gn, fixing vertices V1, etc., Vi. And the beta is a positive constant. So here we say that there are so many ways to extend our vertices V1, etc., Vi to vertices V1, etc., Vi plus 1, such that these I plus 1 vertices would also be extended to a special T set. The second part is that the number of the total number of Vi plus 1, etc., Vt, extending V1, etc., Vi to a special T set is rather small, OB of 1. Then T plus 1 law holds. So here we either have the number of ways to extend given vertices to a special T set is either very small or very large. Okay, and now about disproof of 0,1 k laws. We'll consider the following property of subgraphs, spinning subgraphs D of Dn. For any V1, etc., Vi that can be extended to a special T set with edges in Dn, there exist vertices extending given vertices to a special T set with edges in D. And we'll use this property the following way. Let us denote by K the number of ways to extend vertices V1, etc., Vi to a special T set with edges in Dn. And if we have a set of vertices V1, etc., Vi, say that this number K is not O big of 1 as in the previous statement here, but tends to infinity, and it's is also not too large, the number of vertices to the power of O little of 1, then for this property L, its probability can approach any number from the interval 0, 1. But here there is one problem. This property L is not a first order property, and we should replace it by a first order property looking like this one, where Q is some first order formula which approximates the statement that either we can't extend these vertices to a specialty set with edges in Gn, or this set V1, etc., Vt is a specialty set, and it has edges in the random subgraph. So that's the main idea of the proof. Thank you for your attention.